107.5 WGCI is the Shy's number one for hip-hop and R&B. Baby, it's the morning show with the destined legend Leon Rogers, beautiful Kendra G, the shortest damn man in Chicago, myself, Kyle. And listen, man, today we got a guest in the studio. This is kind of dope. I like
comedy
this.
Comedy royalty, baby.
Yes, she's been hitting the stages, doing her thing for years. You see her on the talk every day. Miss Sheryl Underwood.
Yay! Thank you for shouting out my good CBS job. We come back September the 10th. You know, we just had T.I. on last season.
Okay.
And what my proudest moment on the talk was he was talking recidivism with Sharon Osbourne. So, you know, that's what we do over at the talk. But then I get my coin on with Funny You Should Ask. Byron Allen?
Yeah.
Thank you, Byron Allen.
Hey, that's me. Big sis, they don't know about Byron Allen. Yeah. Byron Allen, that dude behind the scenes.
He got an Instagram page?
But what's fun about it is Funny You Should Ask is one of those game shows where you see comics that you know, and you don't know if our question is real or, you know, we making it up or it's the truth. And it's so fun. And being on the U and this being the kickoff week at 8 o'clock, 8:30, you got to watch it. And youngins, y'all gonna really love this show because you see people that you know. When you got Bill Bellamy and Billy Gardell, when you got comics that you be like, oh, I know that dude, oh, I know that lady, then you're going to really be able to enjoy it. It's a lot of fun.
Funny You Should Ask. That's the name of
the
show.
Yes, that's the name of the show.
That's right, the U.
So Underwood is telling you to watch the U. You're going to dig it. It's 8 o'clock, 8:30. You'll still be able to check it out, and it's family friendly. So, you know, a lot of us still living at home with our grandparents and our aunties. You'll be able to watch this. You know, I won't be wilding out. Oh, can I say this, too? Now, you know, we comics from way back.
Absolutely.
The Shy City Comedy Jam is coming October
5th
and 6th.
That's going to be crazy. Ground.
It's going to be ugly. We all need to come back and sit in with y'all.
Okay. Earthquake.
That was fun. Quay.
You.
Yeah.
Lavelle.
Yeah.
That show about to be ignorant.
Wait a minute. Is Cowboy Wayne on the show,
Country
right?
Wayne.
Country Wayne. Country Wayne.
And that's Cowboy Wayne.
We were just talking about that, like how the whole comedy thing has shifted to like the Instagram. People.
Yes.
And I said, I don't have a problem with them creating a new lane.
Right.
But it's when you say you're a stand-up comic, I'm going to challenge you because this
that's
is a
right.
different thing that we do.
That's
and
right.
he's one of the guys that has mastered coming over into that.
Absolutely.
That
I think DC Young
DC Fly. Yeah.
Did you see that beef he just got into with on Girl?
Yeah, yeah.
When he was saying, you know,
Azalea
that just
broke.
Yeah.
No, okay, dude, not because me and you were the same complexion.
That's
Azalea
right. Real
Banks.
Talk, real talk.
Did you feel her point? Did you feel her point in saying that she felt as though it was racist because she's a chocolate girl and bigging up Cardi B?
Colorism,
what did you feel about
yeah.
that?
Well, listen to me. I love Cardi B. I'm glad that she came up from where she started
right.
and everything. That means you can start from anywhere and make it. You know what I'm saying? I think if you're sensitive to that, you're sensitive to that. You know, when you live in the shot, you walk down the street as a chocolate girl, you little fine brown frame right there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That makes you feel good about being black.
Right.
Man, don't go down to the Bud Billiken parade. You be like, what? What? I am fine. What? So, you know, I sort of understood, but I felt it was a stretch. But I always try to side with the sisters, especially a lot of us don't bag. Well, would you say that? I don't bag because I'm going to go straight to your mama. I'm going to go straight to the realness
of
your
family. So what she's saying is, like, when we say bagging on each other, like we roasting each other, some
playing
people don't get into that because some people go for the jugular.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay,
like, I'll let you get a few of them, then I'll be like, okay.
Right.
Because
yeah.
when I start...
Going,
you don't want
to
fight.
You don't get joned
okay.
on.
Yeah.
So if she's sensitive to that, but I didn't get. So is she saying that Cardi is more acceptable because she's lighter
skin? Oh, most definitely. She said that a few times. About
she said
just,
that.
Yeah.
She said that openly. She said there have been plenty of women of color, dark skin color, who are just as talented or even more talented, but did not get the push that her or Beyonce.
Well, but the music game is just like that. You look at NDRE, you look at when Alicia Keys came out and everything, but you got to make your own lane. That's why, when for me, all of my career, if you tell me no, I believe God just said not right now.
Right.
So I'm going to make my own hustle.
Mm-hmm.
That's why when I decided, I was like, I want to do radio. I'm already on people's shows, but I want my own thing. So I put my own podcast together. But I took my CBS money. That's like me saying, well, Tiffany Haddish is only making it because
of.
And I'm not going to down another sister just for me to stand tall, even if I feel like I should have got. But I'm not an actress comic. I'm a comic.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a hard drinking comic. Yeah, chug all
and
vitamins
also,
down with vodka. I'm that girl.
And to be fair to Azalea Banks too, it wasn't just about light skin. It was because Cardi B is not African American. She's Dominican.
But I guess, but don't let black and brown, don't let them separate us.
Okay.
See, that's what comedy is. We all come together. Like, I always shout out George Lopez, right? Because George Lopez stepped up for me in ways I didn't even know. And then once I got a chance to meet him, and he came on a talk, I said, listen to me. You don't understand what you've done in my life, because people will tell you who your fairy godfather is. You know what I'm saying? So black and brown need to come together, especially now more than ever.
Yeah, no,
we got to register people to vote. We got to get ready for the midterms. We got to do what we got to do. And we got to step up our entertainment game, because once you stack that money, then you can do good in the neighborhood.
And I feel like if you're going to be mad at something, you got to be mad at the system, not the next
yes.
person. You know what I mean? Like, you don't be mad at Cardi B, but
that's right.
If there is a legitimate beef, we can say that.
That's
but
right.
You get mad at the system for the way it's set up.
And you know it struck a nerve if that's where you went. If you, they were saying, well, come back then. Well, everybody don't Joan. Everybody yeah. can't play the dozen. Everybody don't do that. You got to give them some setup
yeah.
because this is not what you do. And it's my understanding, DC Young Fly always go on the ugly tip.
Yeah.
And for some people, it's very sensitive, but that's his joke.
Right.
That's his thing.
Right.
You know, see, for me, you're not going to get off an ugly joke on me. I already talk about the fact that without these braids, I look like Rick Ross. I need to lose some weight. Buffalo Wild Wings. You know, I already talked
about it. It's Wingstop.
It's Wingstop. It's Wingstop. It's Wingstop. It's Wingstop. Is that the one connected with the Pizza Hut?
No, no.
Which one is he? Which one? Is
that's Wingstop. He got
liver pepper. You know, but
you
like when you watch me on the top, you notice that every year, the first year I did James Brown, right? Second year, did Little Richard. Killed the game as Little Richard. So comics that know who they are.
Wrong.
Oh, my gosh. Ooh, I was killing the game. Blew my knees out. But then if you look at Funny You Should Ask, if they write something and we write something that is a question to my appearance, that's a foundation of comedy. Look at when you're talking about Phyllis Diller. You know,
everybody knew
Phyllis Diller, old white female comic from back in
wore
the day.
Wore the long gloves.
But that's right. Her thing was she wasn't fine. And you know it. So I'm going to own it before you can go against me. Do I know I am 65 pounds overweight? Yes, I am. But if I wasn't living so good, I might be able to lose this weight because I don't have the money to eat things like lobsters.
Right. I want
to
ask you a question.
Like Eminem and 8 Mile.
That's right. You better speak up.
Exactly.
Speak up.
So let's remember that Funny You Should Ask airs tonight, 8 and 8:30.
8 and 8:30.
On you. You mentioned Tiffany Haddish. I want to bring up, you know, recently was announced that she got her Netflix
absolutely.
Deal. And obviously, when you think of it, the first thing that comes to mind is
Monique.
Because Monique had the whole boycott.
Mm-hmm.
As a person that can talk on it, because you are a female comic.
Y'all are not giving up your Netflix. I don't even know where that came from.
You came from Monique.
You got a better chance of voting to let Omarosa come to the cookout, then y'all giving up your Netflix. It's not gonna happen.
You got
happen.
A better chance of walking through a pack of lines with pork chop drawers.
That's right. That's, how we gonna Netflix and chill if I gave up my Netflix?
Right.
That's
chill.
That's what this
go
y'all
chill.
Need to do. They, you know, because I be dating youngest, and they be like, Sheryl, come on Netflix and chill. I be like, okay, I got the chill part. I'm gonna be sleep soon as you start your Netflix, because I'm old school like a mug. But one thing I would say about Monique, she was making a point. But your numbers don't lie. Tiffany Haddish, numbers don't lie. You may say, well, she don't breathe fire. Everybody's not going to breathe fire as a comic. I didn't want to be the girl comic. I didn't want to be the black comic. I wanted to be the best comic. And when Chris Rock said on the 25-year anniversary of Def Comedy Jam, the two people he couldn't follow was Bernie Mac and Sheryl Underwood.
Yeah.
That made people blowing up my phone wanting to know who am I now. Because we're the 80s and 90s comics. We're the middle-aged comic now. That's why Funny You Should Ask is so necessary for us, because people are rediscovering us. I want my own sitcom. I want to make movies. I want to have my own Insecure on HBO.
Right.
But from my age perspective, because these youngest be coming at me because I got the coin. You know what I'm saying? I got the coin. And then I'm driving around in a convertible Bentley. You know, I'm looking fly. You know, so the youngest is trying to holler at me. That is a show. That is a show.
They want
right
you to be their sugar mama.
Listen to me. And I cannot pay for anything. And, you know, me and Monique, you know, you remember we was kind of beefing.
Yeah, I was going to say, are you guys cool now?
You listen to me. I was always cool with her. She was the one doing this. And I was never against her. I just felt like remember I talked about the Queens of Comedy on the talk?
Yes.
That I dialed into the call. I was trying to uplift them as the comics, because you always hear about the kings, never hear about the queens, and then to say they blessed me with knowledge of what was thought about me so I could correct myself, so I could get this coin and advance my career. That's what I was trying to say. I'm not against no sister. I'm not down to no other sister. But sometimes when you make a misstep, not saying she did, because you know she will record you and play it. Tyler Perry. Damn. You know. But I do feel like you can't get on stage angry, Leon, tell him. And you can't say for Tyler Perry, Lee Daniels, and Oprah Winfrey to do an activity on you that a lot of us take very, very serious. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, we got it.
Real talk.
But in all fairness, though, Big Sis, she's kind of right about Lee Daniels, because Dame Dash had to press him.
Right.
About keeping your word.
Okay.
About keeping your word. That's about being 100. When you say something, you do it. But keeping your word.
I agree with you, but I agree with you too that listen, this is a different situation. Dame Dash, he knew he owed him money. You had to step to a brother. You had to pull him aside, and you got to bless him. They didn't know they was gonna be at the Diana Ross concert together. You think this is hard to get? Listen to me. I work for CBS. I was like, y'all got the Diana Ross ticket. What's happening? You know, nobody was giving up their Diana Ross tickets at the Hollywood Bowl. So, but it's different. What was you going to say?
I was going to just say that the scenario is like, his was about money. Monique is about saying that he allegedly blackballed her. And, you know, she has issues with a lot of other people, with everyone. Steve Harvey, Oprah, Tyler Perry.
And Steve tried to talk to her.
Yeah,
and Tyler Perry tried to talk to her. Then she records the call. See, that's what everybody fears now, that I can't talk genuine to you. But to your point.
But is she recording because she feel like you're not going to keep your word? You're doing an Omarosa.
You recording everybody in case you need to use it later. But the issue is, I do believe when she showed those emails, she did have emails. But in this business, you will go all the way to it and not get the job.
Right.
And ain't nothing you could do about it. Right. I've gone up for a lot of things and didn't get the job. Do you know that I was asked about the Players Club? Because they knew, long story long, that back on Stony Island, I used to be a lingerie model. Hey. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But yeah, the model, you would wear the lingerie and then you had to, you know, I was in college, right? But God let you know what you can't do. I was horrible at it. So I started making people laugh. I'm doing the Fred Sanford, you know, with the knee.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I was making these goons laugh so hard. They were like, oh, you a trip. Go home, girl. Go home. You are the horriblest stripper in the world. So they let you know what you can't do, right? But I was talked about for this part. And I read the script and I said, I can't do it. And they said, why? I said, because I'm not that good of an actress that I can disregard that in a few more pages, the girl gonna get beat up and raped.
Oh, which part? The cousin.
The part where you're supposed to say you're gonna do junior party that eventually goes to Adele Gibbons.
Right.
But they knew I had the skill and the background because of what I was trying to do in college. But I said, I can't do it because I'm going to want to say to her as a novice actress, girl, don't go do junior party because in five more pages of dialogue you gonna get mollywhopped, you know, and they be like, cut, that's not where you're supposed to go with the script. Right. Well, now I got a chance to do Master P, I got to hook up too.
Yeah.
And now I take the opportunities as they come, but I'm saying this point. Monique is a great actress.
I love Monique too.
All of this stuff is a distraction to her greatness. And now what I would recommend, and she may not listen to me, you have to come back on the comeback tour. That means you got to do stuff like Funny You Should Ask so that people will rediscover you and trust that when you come, it ain't going to be no tripping. Who did I walk in with? By myself with the people that work at Funny You Should Ask.
Right.
You know, and they jumped in the car. We was like, let's go. And then we came up here. But I'm a different type of comic. You know what I'm saying? I'm a worker comic. I'm not against Monique. I just feel like I don't want her to be misunderstood because she's so talented.
Let's bring it back to you, though, for me, because we did a lot of talking about Monique. But you're on this show.
Who we love.
That's right.
Funny, and it's a good story.
Funny You Should Ask. You talked about people rediscovering you. The fact that you're from here in Chicago. You mentioned a little bit about being from Stony Island.
Mm-hmm. So what was around Stony, Gresham Elementary School, UIC, would have went to Calumet or Simeon.
I'm always interested in people's backstory. So who is Sheryl Underwood from Stony Island, and what about that young Sheryl Underwood got you to the point where you are now?
Well, I will tell you this. I'm always independent. My father's great comic. You know, my uncle's great comics. They tell these great jokes, and I would lay in the cook and watch them. No, they were just funny at the house. Man, when my husband died, you know, it was so many people there that the police thought we were throwing an illegal party. And they was like, oh, sorry to hear that. You know, because 71st and Halstead over at Callahan's, we was cracking jokes over there. It was so many comics at my husband's funeral that they thought this was some kind of joke or prank, wow, that it wasn't really real. So if you really want to know me, I'm going to stay with the people. I'm going to stay with the street. You know, I love the fact that other people discover me. You know what I'm saying? And I love the fact that I'm on the number one network, CBS. I can do a game show that's on to you, but then I can still come to GCI that I've been listening to for years, yeah, back when we was chasing football players, basketball players, taking them right out, Seagull, the Schick Rick house, taking them right out. That's right, and taking over the rainbow. Over the rainbow. Listen, Rainbow Beach, and listen to me.
Nah, you talking about using the jungle with
listen
that.
Listen, no, because if you, okay, there's two places that if you, first the romance starts at Buckingham Fountain. Right. That's right, because, you know, it's free.
But Rainbow, you go out your 40.
That's, you better say it. You better get that pipe. And see, you kids don't understand. When we used to pull dudes out of Sweet Georgia Brown, take them right across the street to the Seville, and the Zanzibar,
this a 15-minute conversation.
Y'all don't understand. And you get some real tips.
This is how
you
speak
Leon.
Yeah, that's how you speak on it. You speak on it. And but back when we was young, That was the fun thing to do. You go to the after work set, the stepper set, and you know, we didn't have this violent gang banging. You had two dudes stepping against each other. As soon as a dude put down some cardboard and throw that sand down, yeah, and they wearing them pastel suits and they got them finger waves, cause you know what set they claim.
Right.
You better act like you know. So that's Sheryl Underwear all day.
We'll talk Sheryl like
all day.
And that's dope. That's what I've always loved about you. No matter where we at, you get ignorant with it. We could be walking past and then be like, Shantan, nigga, my boys!
That's
true. Right. Talk about coming from that, what I call the golden age of comedy, the Def Jam era.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You, Bernie,
yes,
Robin Harris, you know, y'all all set that off, man. Like,
it's the black comedy explosion.
What was that like? I mean, what was that like, and compared to what's going on in comedy now?
Well, you know, I like that there's a social media component to this, but I think they need time, because this business will grind you up. So they'll give you job after job after job, but what you don't have is the experience. We have experience. That's why I can be the dirtiest curse in this comic and work with Byron Allen, who don't curse at all,
right,
who don't want that material at all, but he trusts your skill enough to put you on Comics Unleashed. He trusts your skill enough to put you on Funny You Should Ask and put you in the mainstream. So hopefully this business doesn't burn you out. But when we were doing comedy, there was a bottleneck that the black adult urban comic didn't have a spot. So when Russell Simmons, the way I heard this, he went to Apollo Comedy Hour with Monteria Ivy in New York. So he wanted to do for comedy what he did for hip-hop, mm-hmm, bring it to the mainstream. So they came up with Def Comedy Jam, and there were other comics. They were looking at Robin Harris, God rest his soul, you know, and he goes on to be with God. That's right. And then they were looking at, my understanding, Jante Brown, and they were looking at Martin Lawrence. So Martin Lawrence comes up through Star Search. That's why mainstream is necessary. You know, you gotta be discovered by them, so that legitimizes you. But then, that's when you saw everybody had a sitcom, which moved over to the movie. So you got a Chris Tucker, you know what I'm saying? You got Martin, you got Jamie Foxx. Where was the girl to have that? Monique got on the Parkers because of a beef with people, you know, people, not her beef, but it was two people on Brandy's show. They was beefing, so they spent it off for the Parkers. And that's how she got it. They already had a mother for the Parkers, but they saw Monique at the Montreal Comedy Fest. She tore the roof off the sucker, and that's how she got it. We need opportunities to get it back.
And before that, Thea.
Thea Vidal. Look at Steve, me and the boys.
Yeah.
That's so you, when you see the Bernie Mac show,
yep,
and but look how long it took. If you put God first, everything else falls into place. But when you're talking about the golden age, when we were doing Def Comedy Jam, it was like Freaknik for comics. You know, everybody would run everybody's room. You would see who's kicking with who. You know, you was like, oh, okay, you take the elevator this floor, then we're going to walk down these stairs.
Then if you was an alternate, you'd be like, y'all stay right
here. That's right, y'all speak on it. And then if you didn't have had your outfit right. It was everybody really trying to help each other. Yeah. But we were all young in the game. So we are the old heads. Got to remember that these youngins need us. They need us because they need the time. They don't have the time. They don't know what to do when the lights go out. Yeah. You may have the following, but you don't have it the time. So we got to pray that you get time.
But how hard is it to crack? Because I like a lot of them
yeah.
that do their thing on Instagram. But because they have 2 million followers, because they have 3 million, and they might look at you and you only got 600,000.
That's right.
They feel like in Instagram, them having the 3 million.
I got 125K. I'm going to start posting.
They feel like them having 3 million followers makes more. Them better. But right. then when we get on that stage.
I'm telling you, Bomb. The equalizer's when you bomb. And I'm gonna tell you something. You know, when comics bomb, you go up as the hero. When you bomb, everybody turning away from you like you got Ebola down your throat.
And you trying to get to your car. You don't even yeah. wait for people to
yeah,
talk to you.
They ain't got nothing for you, man.
Have you bombed before?
Woo! Child, listen to me.
You're not a comic until you do.
Yeah, until you choke. I tell you, you don't know what to do, man. You and then, like, what I've learned is when you do a TV show, you do what got you invited. But you also better understand how to pivot out of something a producer picked
that ain't gonna work.
Because right. they ain't gonna blame the producer. They gonna look at you like you not funny. And that's the thing about doing Funny You Should Ask. This is produced by a comic. So he knows timing. He knows what your voice is. And you gotta have time to find your voice. Tiffany Haddish got 2 movies coming out, right? How long do you think it's going to take? Amy Schumer was the bomb, wasn't she? Until one of the movies didn't do well.
Right.
Listen to me. And then what happened? Bring us Tiffany Haddish. And she's killing the game. Now what we got to do is the old heads go, all right, look, pump your brakes. Go away for a little while. Like, I'm not an actress. I can act. I can be taught to act. I've been on Young and the Restless, Bold and the Beautiful, The Odd Couple, Bullworth. I got to hook up Beauty Shop. And all that stuff in Beauty Shop is ad-lib. Queen Latifah let me ad-lib. When I said, can I do something? And she said, yeah. I said, let me show you something. I said, every time I say monkey bread, I'm going, eh! And she was like, you know, before we got mad about it. You know what I'm saying? Right. Real talk. So I'm killing the game, right? Everybody laughing. She was like, keep that in. So one scene grew to me being in the entire movie. Ooh. So what I'm saying to you is, in the golden age, we had time to learn. We had time to fail. We had time to figure out who we are. These people don't have it anymore because social media means you're on
microwave all
the time. Yeah. Yes, and you think that the people, those 2 million people that you plan to, then, yeah, you're going to come to the club and see this person. Are you coming to the movie? Mm-hmm. Are you going to buy 5 tickets? You know what I'm saying?
But when that first 5 minutes, well.
Absolutely.
That's right.
Absolutely.
You still got 25 to fill.
And if people say we hating because we old school.
That's...
Oh. But I was going to say this. I will say just let them learn on their own. Like, I guess I shouldn't bother too much how they learn.
I feel you, but that's bad for the game. But because we love this thing that we do called comedy,
it's
so much,
mob.
It's like radio. It's you like wouldn't want somebody hip-hop. To come on here
yeah,
and
yeah,
sound
yeah,
trash
yeah,
because
way.
That's killing your game. This thing that you do. Like, I feel like comedy is an art form for us.
Yes.
And I put a lot into it. And I know the struggles. And I've watched
That's right.
my big sisters and big brothers.
And then we go, well, why we can't get a shot now? Because somebody was feel like step up. Remember when Samuel Jackson was talking about rappers doing movies and
yeah.
being actors and stuff? Like, for me, look at rap now. Mumble rap is, I'm concerned. You know, we used to, you know, we used to make money about drug dealing. Now we seem to make music about drug use.
Yeah.
Because that stuff slow you down. And you know, you ain't trying to go nowhere. You know, but I can't say that because that's what they like.
Absolutely.
You know, but
it's
I'm
not
looking
for me.
But I'm looking for where's Eric B and Rakim? You know, we got it in Kendrick Lamar. We got it in J. Cole. Uh-huh. But I need to see a group come together. Grandmaster Flash and Furious 5 with these youngins. I need to see where's the next OJ? Where's the next? Are
well,
you going to
OJ?
Sure, sure.
No, I mean,
punch Zach Boog in his face, and you know what?
I mean, from the young perspective, like, okay, remember when they had LaVert,
yeah.
Gil, and who was the two?
LSG.
LSG, yeah. Man, listen, you didn't get off that LSG, it's not to be got. You might as well just don't
and
go
And they
home.
Tried it with Genuine
at TGT.
But they had drama.
That's right.
But they had drama.
My, listen to me. The youngins right now, Trey Song and 2 other dudes. The Bobby Brown story, you better check it out when it comes up to
Boy, we know why you on the talk, Sheryl.
Well, I just want to, I got to get on it. Because GCI be like, look, who said? But I just want to tell you. You youngins, y'all can put together singing groups. Y'all can put together bands. Y'all can be groups together. Because I got to have the one that I like. I got to have the light skin. I like, somebody that look like an El DeBarge or something that's young, you know?
So you're saying, where is this generation's temptations? Where is the new edition?
That's right.
DMC just made that point in that video that he dropped. He was saying if there was a group of artists that you like, everybody has somebody individually in that group that they like the most. You might like Ronnie, but somebody else might have liked Bobby Brown.
That's right.
Somebody else might
have liked Bobby Brown. You guys think about it too much. You know, solo's better. Look at Beyonce.
Well, yeah, but she had to be Destiny Child before she could get all of that. That's right. And then she had to. Did y'all see the footage a long time ago where old girl failed?
Yep.
And they were so professional, they just stepped right over when she fell. So I was like, damn.
Shout out to Sheryl.
But listen to me. And she was on our show. She was on our show too. But I'm going to tell you what's good about this. We're talking about history. And we're talking about, for us, recent history. So we remember when Beyonce was in, was it Time's Up? What was the group? Was it the little bitty girl?
Oh, yeah, it's before that.
Girl's Time. That's right.
And that's what I'm talking about, Sheryl. I think social media kills that you had to be there moment. See, like how you sat there and told a story about 79, I painted a picture in
my mind. That's right.
But when
people go
to concerts now, they're so busy trying to record the event, you're not even enjoying what's happening.
Absolutely.
Right now.
Absolutely. And to me, if you get, I want to see some mashup with some old hair. Why are you looking at me like that?
Because he one of them tight pants, lean drinking, pill popping kids.
That's not true.
I can't get with the pants sagging. You can't be my man with the pants. I need to hear a belt buckle clingle. I need to hear some change come out that pocket and that wallet hit the.
Are you dating?
It's time to make the donuts, baby. So she hit that belt buckle. Yes. That's right. Yes, Lord. Am I dating?
Yes.
Yeah. If you ask me and if you come pick me up before 5:30. I'm old school like a bug.
What time you got to be in by?
Now, let me tell you something. Oh, 7:30. You better catch me before the nightly news.
The white bus with the beeping ain't coming.
Listen
to
me. But I'm going
to
tell you something. What I like, I don't care how old you are. I don't care what you do. But if you want to snuggle with me in one of the finest hotels in the world and we have dinner and we snuggle, because I ain't giving up nothing, because Jesus be back in 48 hours. Play if you want to. Play if you want to. Because I'm not getting turned out and looking stupid and somebody be telling business, you know. And I've dated a lot of guys and dated some youngins. You know, I date the athletes, you know.
It got to be tough for you in your position, all right? To deal with, not know who to trust, not know if they want to date you just because you're on TV or you got money. And how do you maneuver through
all
that?
No, you know, because I'm kind of like a dude. You know, when I be like, hey, this date is over. Look at the time, you know. Yeah, I walk you right up out the hotel room, put my hand right in your back. Good night. Hey, good night. I got time to go to bed because I'm grown.
So hotel, not your place. I saw you.
Oh, no. I'm not doing nothing in my place. No, you can't know where I live and you coming back and you staking out and everything. But I will lay up in somebody else's house and let them sit outside their house waiting on me to come back because I'm old school. Older women know the game. We know the game. That's why young dudes like us. And I got all the cereals. I got all the... You can play Fortnite till the cows come home. Because I got TVs in every room. And I got the retractable bed. So you can sit up in Fortnite to death. Why? Because I'm in the bed. I went to bed 3 days ago.
I got all I went to bed three days ago.
Listen to me. All the cereals. And I got every kind of milk you like.
Me.
I got the almond.
The cats.
Listen to me.
Sure, you are hilarious.
These youngins love me. I got the tennis shoes. I just... They open the door and all the tennis shoes.
You got the convertible Bentley too.
Listen to me. And then this is when I really put the finishing touch on it. I hand them the keys and go put some gas in my car.
Ooh. Oh,
the
gas.
Sheryl Underwood hanging out with us today, Chicago. Sheryl,
you gonna shout out your people. I know you never leave a mic without shouting out.
Shout out Zeta Phi Beta. Yes, shout out all my family members, every Underwood, everybody that know me from back in the day. Don't forget, we got Funny You Should Ask.
That's right.
You got to watch it. 8 o'clock, 8:30 on the U. Then October 5th and 6th, you got the Chi-Town Comedy Jam. Is it Chi-Town, Chi-City?
Chi-City
Comedy Jam. Blake, the dude that promote this, own Harold's Chicken. That's why we support. And we got something we getting ready to do. He owns some Harold's Chickens. And I love Harold's Chicken. I need to do a commercial. Yeah. But listen to me. The reason we doing all this, we got some good things coming with the youngins on HBCUs, and Blake is going to join us. We doing some things. Oh, I know what we didn't talk about.
Right.
What you think my boy gonna do with the Lakers? LeBron.
Oh, we had that.
Come on, you might as well. Stop playing.
Me and you can rap about that.
You don't love the Lakers?
No, I don't love the Lakers.
I like LeBron James, though. Wherever he goes, the team is gonna do better.
You 76ers?
Yeah.
Wait a minute, when the last time 76ers was hot?
No, I mean, honestly, when we had Iverson. But that's not what determines your loyalty. Yeah. Your loyalty is you have a loyalty to your team.
You should be a Bulls fan. I'm a Bulls
fan. I am a Bulls fan.
Okay, well, you shouldn't be talking to me about no Lakers.
I'm a LeBron James fan.
You shouldn't be talking to me about no Lakers.
No, see, the reason I got to do it is because I got to get my coin in L.A. So he about to bring entertainment to L.A. That's why I was
green light.
Sound like a cop out to me.
No, he already green lighted one film, though.
Listen to me. All right, y'all better. Hey, this is the shout out for the
Lakers versus Bulls. Who you rooting for?
Bulls. I'm rooting for the Bulls.